Welcome to Vinix Studio. Let's start making games.
And welcome. In this tutorial, we are going to see how to create a day-night cycle in Unity. So, in the default scene, a directional light is added by Unity, and we are going to use that directional light to give the effect of day and night. So, let's select the directional light. And as you can see, the directional light has a transform rotation of 30, 40, and 50. So, let's reset it. So now you can see it looks something like a sunset or sunrise. And if you change the rotation in x-axis of the directional light, so as you go on increasing, the light keeps rotating and it goes from sunrise to sunset at 180 degrees, and then it's night time. So at 360, it will be back to sunrise. So you basically have to rotate your directional light in the x-axis so that it will be able to mimic the day-night cycle. So to do that, let's reset this to zero. And let's add a new script to our directional light. Click on add component. Let's call it day and night. So now we have added a day-night script to our directional light. Let's open it in Visual Studio Code for editing. And we don't need these two using function. Then we'll not be using start, so let's delete that too. And let's create a vector 3. And let's call it rot. And we'll initialize it to zero, so vector 3.0. And now we need a float, which will be the degrees to turn per second. Well, be degrees per second, and let's have maybe 6 degrees per second. Now let's go to the update and assign the vector 3's x value with your degree per second multiplied with time dot self time. So that means for every second your x-axis will rotate by 6 degrees. And to rotate the actual directional light, let's go to transform dot rotate in the brackets. It will be your rot comma space dot world. So that's it for the script. Let's go back to Unity. Unity will load the script, and better to set the directional light's rotation to zero. You can do this in the start function also. So now let's play the game, and you can see. So in order to see it better, let's add a cube and a plane to our scene. Reset the position and then let's lift the cube a little bit to the top so that you'll be able to see the shadow. And now let's play the game. Okay, so there you go. So you can see the shadow moving. So in 1 minute it will start from zero and reach 360. So that's it. Now you have created a day-night cycle. You can use it in your game, and you can check the x value of the directional light to know whether it is day or night. See you in the next tutorial. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.